Hello, my name is Robby Firdaus Rahman. I am a History Education Study Program Class 2023. In this video, I want to tell you about Tan Malaka, the Forgotten Hero. You probably heard this quote before, Tuan Rumah tidak akan berunding dengan maling yang menjala rumahnya. Or in English, Homeowner will not negotiate with thief who loot their homes. These words were spoken by Tan Malaka. Who is Tan Malaka? Tan Malaka is one of Indonesia's national heroes. He was born on June 2, 1897 in Pandam Gadang, West Sumatra. Tan Malaka was born with the name Sultan Ibrahim, and he has a title Datuk Tan Malaka. Tan Malaka died on February 21, 1949 in Selo Panggung, Kediri. Ironically, he died at the hands of his own people, the people and the nation he fought for. Tan Malaka was declared as an Indonesian national hero on March 28, 1963, signed by President Soekarno, based on RI Decree No. 53. Tan Malaka is a small and skinny man with a neat, slick back hair. According to his teacher, Horensma, young Tan Malaka is a disobedient and naughty boy, but he is very kind and smart. He is an honest and sincere man according to his brother. Since childhood, he has studied Islamic religion and memorized the Quran since he was 10 years old. And he also learned pencak silat martial arts. And now, we get to the point why he was a national hero. He was the first person to write the concept of the Indonesian Republic, even before Soekarno and Hatta. Because of his book titled Nar the Republic Indonesia, or Menuju Republik Indonesia, contains the opportunity for Indonesia to carry out the revolution against Dutch imperialism and colonialism. This book also an inspiration for many figures in the Indonesian struggle movement. Tan Malaka's struggle is not only in the political area, but in the educational area as well. He was a teacher, and he also built a school. You might ask why he was killed by his own people. It's because of his consistent resistance to the government of Republic Indonesia, which he considered to be soft and compromising toward the Dutch, and also perhaps because of his left-wing communism ideology. He was killed by the Sikatan Brigade on the order of the high-ranking military official in East Java. He was killed by execution. So much his love and concern for his country that he put aside his personal matters. He died unmarried. The moral value that I can take from Tan Malaka is the persistence in achieving what we want and never give up whatever the circumstances. I think that's all I can tell you about the story of Tan Malaka, the forgotten hero. Thank you so much for your attention. See you later. Have a good day.